What is a home appraisal? When is it needed? And then what exactly is it based on? That's what we're talking about today. Stick around. Hi, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Jill Heidrich. I'm a local realtor here in Lexington, South Carolina. I post videos about what it's like to live and work here in the Midlands and guidance on buying, selling, and investing in the area. If this is something that interests you, go ahead and consider hitting that subscribe button below. And don't forget to hit the bell so that you're notified of the new videos I release on Fridays. In this week's video, we're talking all about home appraisals. What is a home appraisal? When do you need one? And what exactly is the home appraisal based on? Does the appraisal stick with the property? Well, stay tuned till the very end to find out. When a licensed home appraiser comes out to the property to do a thorough inspection of the property, they're going to be looking at all the details of the property and how they compare to the market. What they're trying to do is determine a true market value for the property. The licensed appraiser will put together an appraisal report once they've finished with all of their findings. Now let's talk about the five different situations when a home appraisal would be needed. Number one, if you're a buyer and you're getting financing on the property, your lender is probably going to require that you get a home appraisal completed. Number two, if you're a homeowner and you're looking to refinance, whichever bank or lender you're using for the refinancing is going to require a home appraisal to be done. Number three, if you're a homeowner and you're looking to get a home equity loan, well, then you're going to need an appraisal to see how much equity is actually available on the property. Number four, if you're a homeowner and you're looking to get another type of a loan, such as a business loan, and you're planning to use your home as collateral, you're going to need a home appraisal done to know what the fair market value of your property is. And the last situation where a home appraisal might be needed is if you're a homeowner and you're thinking about selling and you want to get an idea of what a fair market value is on the home, you can consider getting an appraisal before you go on the market. Now let's talk about what an appraisal is. A home appraiser is going to consider all the details and aspects of a home that's going to affect the value. Like, what is the overall condition of this home as compared to all the other comparable homes? Have there been any upgrades or additions made to the property recently? They're going to take photos to note the conditions both inside and outside of the property. They're going to measure everything to make sure they have the correct square footage of both the house and the lot. Sometimes the home appraiser will actually pull the tax records to confirm this information. And they're also going to take into consideration the market conditions of the neighborhood, the town, the county, and the state in which the property is located. Now, once the appraiser is done with their inspection of the property, they're going to compile everything into a report, like I said earlier. Now, if you've ordered a home appraisal and receive your report, make sure to look over it. It's very, very detailed. They're going to give you a fair market price for the home, and this may or may not be the list price or even the contract price. This is the third-party objective opinion from the licensed appraiser. They're actually going to give you a cost appraisal as well, meaning if the entire structure burned to the ground tomorrow and you had to rebuild it, this will show you about how much it would cost. An appraisal report is also going to know the conditions of the property. So, for example, if you're getting an FHA or a VA loan, there's other conditional things about the property that the appraiser is going to look for. Things like peeling paint or safety concerns. So if any of those things need to be called out by the appraiser for those specific financing situations, they'll do that on the report as well. Then you might be asking yourself, well, how long is the appraisal really good for? Most banks and lending institutions won't actually entertain any appraisals older than 6 months because the real estate market, as you know, is ever-changing. And it could be a really drastic difference from 6 months ago to today what your home would be worth. It's important to know if you're a seller that has an FHA or VA buyer where the appraisal came in low and you weren't able to come to terms and had to part ways. that the VA or FHA appraisal actually does stay with the property for a certain amount of time. Therefore, if you go under contract right away with another FHA or a VA buyer, there's a chance that that appraiser is going to pull the old report and it could underappraise again. Just for your references, an FHA appraisal will stick with the property for 120 days or 4 months. A VA appraisal will stick with the property for 6 months. Stay tuned to my YouTube channel for future videos and we'll talk more about appraisers. What do you do and what are your options when the home appraisal comes in too low? And if you're a seller, what can you do to get your home prepared now to maximize your appraised value? If you enjoyed this video or learned something new today, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell to keep you updated when I post videos. Of course, don't forget to push the like button too. Again, my name is Jill and I'm your real estate expert for the Columbia Midlands area. Thank you so much for joining me this week.
This is Jill Heidrich with Exit Real Estate Consultants, and Columbia is my town.